As our modern crop of ECUs have become more advanced, they're now in control of more functions beyond just supplying fuel and ignition to our engine. And one area where we can really utilise the ECU is providing some safety functions to protect the engine if something goes wrong. With the MoTeC M1 ECU fitted to the 2013 Subaru STi behind me, English Racing are incorporating a number of these features, such as monitoring oil pressure, fuel pressure, and coolant system pressure. Let's talk about how those functions work and how they can potentially save the engine. First of all, when it comes to the oil pressure, we always need to make sure that we have sufficient oil pressure being supplied to the engine bearings. However, we can't just say, for example, that 15 PSI of oil pressure is going to be safe. The correct oil pressure really depends on the engine RPM, and as a rough rule of thumb, we need about 10 PSI per 1000 RPM. What this means is that 10 to 20 PSI of oil pressure may be absolutely safe and reliable at idle, but at 6 to 7,000 RPM, we probably need 60 to 70 PSI of oil pressure. Inside of the MoTeC ECU, we can set up a table that defines the minimum allowable oil pressure versus engine RPM. This allows us, for example, to have a 10 psi cutoff at 1000 rpm idle, but a 50 psi cutoff at higher rpm, let's say 6 to 7000 rpm. This protects the engine under all circumstances. Next, we've got the fuel pressure. And while monitoring the fuel pressure is great to give the tuner an idea of something's going wrong with the fuel system, once the engine's tuned and it's sent out on the road or the racetrack, it's still possible that something may go wrong with the fuel system. Perhaps the fuel pump may start to die in the factory fuel tank. Under these circumstances, what we can see is the fuel pressure at high RPM and high load start to drop away. Now, in the case of the MoTeC M1, it can actually take this on board and it can compensate for the lower fuel pressure by increasing the injector pulse width. And within reason at least, this means that it can maintain a safe air-fuel ratio even if the fuel system pressure drops a little bit from what's considered ideal. Lastly, we'll talk about the cooling system pressure sensor, and this is here to monitor the pressure in the cooling system in case the head gasket starts to leak. If the head gasket starts to leak, pressure from the combustion chamber is going to begin leaking into the cooling system, and this will see that coolant system pressure spike. Now, by monitoring this, the ECU can put into place safeguards to instantly prevent further damage occurring to the rest of the engine. So if you've got a modern ECU, it's quite possible that you can make use of some of these same safety functions to provide extra reliability to your engine, and with the sake of a few relatively cheap sensors and a little time by the tuner programming these safety features, you can potentially save thousands of dollars worth of expensive engine damage.
If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.